All right, welcome back to Close Up. My next guest this morning, one is a well-known Republican in New Hampshire, the other one a well-known Democrat, but Lou Feldstein and Steve Dupree have teamed up before. They formed an alliance in their opposition to gambling, but now they're doing it again for a much broader and perhaps much more important issue. Gentlemen, good to see you this morning. Thanks for joining us. So the group is called Opportunity Gap on a national scale, Our Kids New Hampshire on a local scale. Steve, take us through it. What is it?
The opportunity gap is a problem. We think it's the biggest domestic problem. When you poll people, they talk about jobs and the economy. But when you dig down, they're saying, my kids aren't getting the same shot at succeeding as I got or that my parents provided for me. And what we're seeing in the research shows is that opportunity gap, which doesn't guarantee everybody succeeds, and it isn't about income inequality, although that's a symptom. It just means that we grew up in America and the dream was everybody, whether you're rich or poor, got the same early start in life and the same educational base to then go out and succeed or fail on your own merit. But what's happened over the last 30 years, and there's a lot of research, and Robert Putnam's book, Our Kids, really lays this out, is that gap's growing. And if you grow up in a poor home, in a single-parent home, your chances of having a fair shot at succeeding or failing are getting less and less.
And
that's
Lou,
the gap.
Lou, this is a message which obviously casts a wide net on a wide range of issues. Whose ears is this message intended to reach?
This is a perfect message for New Hampshire. We want the candidates, the national candidates, to hear it as well, because this is a national issue. It basically means that the Declaration of Independence, that key sentence, all men are created equal, is no longer the case. And if we don't make an effort to make the change, we're going to have tens of millions of kids going out of society, not working, not voting, not being part of things, not trusting anybody. Mostly poor kids.
And Steve just touched on this a little bit, but there's some numbers to back this up that got you guys involved.
Absolutely. And the numbers say unequivocally that the experience of poor kids or working class kids is different than it used to be. They are less likely to do sports in school, less likely to do extracurricular activity, less likely to trust anybody, less likely to have a church that they go to, less likely to have jobs. And when you poll these kids in schools, we find that they are bitter and don't trust anybody. Give you one quote from a girl named Mary Sue, one of these kids. She says, love gets you hurt, trust gets you killed.
And this is an issue, Steve, that obviously, I mean, you're both sitting here together, that Democrats and Republicans are starting to come together and agree on in this campaign. What is the mission of the group itself? I mean, what are you guys trying to accomplish?
So when Lou and I can get together, and we come from different sides of the street politically, we talk to a number of political leaders and emerging. It's truly a purple group we form called Our Kids New Hampshire, probably the most deeply purple group. When you have folks like Dan Feltes, a more moderate, some would say liberal state senator, and Mara Linda Garcia, a good conservative Republican, all agreeing, not on solutions perhaps, but agreeing that it's a big problem. So we came together, it's religious leaders, business leaders, emerging young political leaders. Lou and I are not in that class, but saying we've got to tackle this problem. So our goal first is to make every candidate talk about it. Is it an issue? What are you going to do about it? There have been things the federal government's done in the past, like the earned income tax credit or the child care tax credit, which have helped. But it's beyond a federal issue. We want to have the candidates talk about it. We want to talk about it on the state level. And frankly, you need to talk about it on the local level. A simple thing like pay for play. When you and I went to Kingswood and Kennett, we didn't have to pay to play football regardless. So if you were the poorest kid in town, you got a bus ride home at night, you got to go to every game, you got your equipment, that isn't true anymore. So those kids don't even get to participate. And those soft skills are what make people good citizens. And also, it's just making sure every kid in New Hampshire, sort of the promise, the American dream, was every kid gets an equal place to succeed or fail on their own once they get that start. That's not happening anymore.
So how do you cut through, Lou, this being more of a stump speech and saying, oh, this is something that we need to be fixing and, you know, waving the American flag and saying we need to get our country back? How do you cut through all that to have some real dialogue? Who needs to be at the table to talk about these things?
Our plan is to start with the presidential candidates. We want each of them talking about this here and then elsewhere. And then we expect to, and we will bring in much more of the state of New Hampshire. We need teachers, we need schools, we need people act as mentors, we need parents, we need a lot of people in on this. This is not going to be solved by a single step, nor quickly. Lots of people need to be involved. It won't happen otherwise. It's taken decades to get to this spot. We've got to reverse it as a country.
What's the response been like from the people you've talked to in the presidential field?
There are a lot of candidates who get it. Certainly, Secretary Clinton talks about it. I haven't heard Senator Sanders yet use it, but Jeb Bush talks about the opportunity gap. I think he proofread the book, John Kasich.
Well, opportunity gap is Senator Sanders' the basis of his campaign.
Right, but and he talks more about the income. I think we Republicans say, let's, you know, whether you succeed or fail is after you get through that, but we're not even getting kids to the starting line at the same spot, and that's been what we've sort of focused on, but Jeb Bush is intimately familiar. John Kasich actually came to one of the New Hampshire Listen sessions. We've had sessions around the state to see if this research has been done resonates with people, and boy, did we find out it did. People go, yes, this is exactly what we're dealing with. Marco Rubio talks about it. I think all candidates will, because again, I'm the conservative Republican, and I think the Democrats are focusing on the symptom, the income inequality. What we never guaranteed, the Constitution and the Declaration don't guarantee we're all going to succeed. They're going to guarantee that hopefully we give every kid an equal chance to succeed, regardless of whether you're rich or poor. And a lot of it's just because of the world economy. We got more single parents. Everybody's working harder. There are fewer social groups like the, you know, Rotary and the Police League and things like that. So we don't have that mentorship. And these kids are losing out on developing those skills. And then that just echoes through their ability to learn, to get a good job, and then to make sure that their kids have an equal shot.
And a lot of people always point to the frustration with the gridlock in Washington and the divisive nature of partisan politics. Lou, do you think this is an area where, in an issue, where candidates, elected officials, whoever, can find some common ground and get in the room, start talking about things together? Because this is...
I think our kids, New Hampshire, proves it. This is a group of people that doesn't agree on almost anything. They walk in, they look at each other like, say, oh, I don't want my picture taken with him. But they're here.
Thanks.
I'm crazy.
Well, we got you now.
Yeah. Too late for that, friend.
But they are here, and they will say that this is the most important issue they see for their generation.
So let me ask you, though. I mean, you pointed out there's agreement that this is a problem.
Yeah.
And it's easy to find agreement when it comes to the problems. Solutions is where the parties tend to go different ways. Where do you start? I mean, what is one area where you can say, you know what, this is something where we can both work on and get, you know, the ball rolling?
Well, for example, I mean, and again, we put this group together. So when we get together, you don't talk outside the group. We don't go out and tweet about it, but you just explore things. New Hampshire has a long tradition of, on tough, thorny issues, getting both sides to sit down and hammer things out. I think we all agree that access to affordable child care is really important. When 47% of the 12,500 children born every year in New Hampshire born to single parents, that's automatically an issue. And that's before you get to kindergarten and beyond the all-day, part-of-the-day debate. You know, when you and I grew up, most of the homes had a mom there, regardless of whether you were rich or poor, who was there to provide that nurturing and the reading time and pick you up and take you places and take you to the sports league. That doesn't exist. So I think there's broad consensus that we need to look at things and maybe have some fresh ideas on how do we in New Hampshire provide affordable child care, particularly for folks who are trying to get to school and get enough education so that they don't become wards of the state or rely on the state, things like that.
It would seem to me, and we're almost out of time, but it would seem to me that this is something that really could be sparked at a local level. We talked a little bit about the federal government can do it. So many candidates are like, federal government can't be the answer to everything.
That's one part of it, small part.
Sure.
It could happen nationally, but it'll also mostly happen locally. That's why New Hampshire's got a real edge. We can do this. And it means more to us than it means to most states. With our demographics of getting an older population, less and less young people, we need these young people. We can't afford to lose them. We need to get everyone back in the game. And we've got a huge economic stake. All of us have a stake in it. And one of the interesting measures on this thing is that these kids believe that they don't believe that people trust them. They don't believe that people care about them. 57% high school and grade school kids tested in 2013 said, we do not believe that anyone in the community cares about us. That's a huge number.
Yeah, it is terrifying. We have about a minute to go. Lou, I did want you to follow up on it. Is there an appetite within the local community to address this problem? Because, teachers and schools are going to have to admit, you know what? We have a problem within our schools, and in some ways have to bear some responsibility.
Absolutely. It's not even, it happens immediately. When you have these local hearings Steve talked about, a lot of people turned out. We haven't gone to a place and talked about where people didn't come at us with wanting to say, what do we do, how can we help? They want in, they know they need it. And we need to get people like you to care about it. nothing matters as much as guys like you asking the question of other people as they come and sit in these seats. You ask the question, it puts it on the agenda.
Lastly, Steve, how active is this organization going to be moving forward? How loud are you going to be?
I think we're going to be quite loud. This is our sort of first public event. We're going to, I think people will be surprised when they say how purple this group is. We're going to start with the presidential candidates, but keep this dialogue going right through the primary and after at the state level and at the local level.
Because without the next generation, what do we have, right?
Exactly.
Gentlemen, thanks very much. Appreciate it. Thanks for coming on the show.